Do you like puddles? You into puddles?
A puddles pity party? Fucking clown?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, actually. I've seen some of his stuff that he did with out of that fucking jazz band. Can't remember their name now. But that was all pretty interesting.
He is tall. He's like close to 7 feet tall.
Jesus.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, I know nothing about this. I just Googled it. Holy smokes.
Yeah.
6'8". 6'8".
Holy shit.
55 years old.
I wonder how big his chin is.
Yeah.
Hang on, we kick my dog out.
It looks sizable. Yeah, that's what the internet says right here. I'm not able to confirm that.
You know, Hot Drummer News Babe is who introduced me to Puddle's Pity Party. So she wouldn't know. They saw Hot Drummer News Babe and Mr. Hot Drummer News Babe saw him live at some point.
That's kind of cool. I just seen him in a couple of YouTube videos with some jazz quartet and he was like singing stuff. Yeah. So I liked it.
Yeah, it's good. It's good stuff. All right. We are 8 minutes behind schedule. Ray, you asshole.
We can make it up. Just talk really fast.
Okay, you got it. All right. Hey, what intro should I play tonight? The big one or the normal one?
I don't know. How about the new one? Just because it's so cool.
Just because Dave's here. Okay. All right. Here we go. Mm-hmm.
Wow. Red carpet.
He used to do a World of Warcraft advice podcast. He even did the original Drunken podcast, changing the game and influencing a generation of podcasters. But he was disgraced. Accused of crimes he never committed. Shamed, he disappeared. By the grace and generosity of Mr. Rich Dickman, he was raised again. Seconded by his co-host, definitely not main host, Ray, Rem Dickman has returned, sexier and more handsome than ever. This is The Rich Dickman Show, the greatest podcast ever produced by Rich Dickman with Rem and Ray. Featuring executive producer Randy, producer Ryan, Maddie from Australia, Hot Drummer News Baby, and Svensson. The Rich Dickman Show, your slightly better than mediocre podcast.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to episode 114 of The Rich Dickman Show, the podcast that is slightly better than mediocre. I am your host. I am Rem. I messed up that word. That's okay. I've never done more than 114 episodes of a single podcast. Ray, this might be the last one that we ever do, buddy. How are you?
I'm good. Wait, so this is the last one or next week would be the last one?
Well, this would be my last one. And next week you begin to search for a new co-host. And you might even have one tonight because we have a guest with us, Ray. It is the one and only Dave. Yes, it is. It is, buddy. Welcome back to the show, Dave. From Not for Human Consumption. How are you?
I'm good. How are you guys?
Chilling, man. I like your setup. Good. Got the changing lights.
Thanks.
You got your face on your microphone.
Yeah, it's just a light bulb I bought from Amazon for like $8. I control it with my phone. It's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. Nice. I mean, I got to get that from down here, Ray. I gotta set this shit up because it looks terrible. Oh man! So we are back once again. 114 episodes later, we made it, Ray. We finally did it. I've accomplished my goal. I think. I don't know. Let's see how this one goes. We got updates tonight on the whole Marconin of it all. Dave, I'm sorry. I know you listen every week and you have to sit through that one. So, but you know, we're gonna get to you, bud. We're gonna see what's up with you and how you're doing. I don't have much to say this week, really, Ray. I think we'll get more into it. Well, actually, this is the last time we'll ever talk about it. Ray, what's new in your life, bud? Don't take too much time, because I want to talk to Dave. I like Dave.
Sorry, Dave. We pretty much shouldn't have brought you in. We're going to talk about Marconin the whole episode.
Great.
So, you know, might as well just turn your whole setup off. I'm just chilling. Not really too much going on, trying to... You know what I got to do? I got to play some golf over last weekend. It was just at a just amazingly gorgeous facility. And what's it in the land before time when they go? It was like the Green Valley or something like that. Like it looked
Pangea.
Like that. You get to the end of it was just looked like just green everywhere. It was fantastic. I just gorgeous. So got to go do that and just slice of heaven in Northern California.
Dave, do you know what grass is? Do you have grass in Arizona?
I've seen it before, like when I've been on trips, And, you know, that's about it, though.
Did you know that Arizona grows some of the, like, they manufacture and ship out some of the, like, highest quality grass in the world?
I did not.
Yeah.
That's fucked up. You know, but here's one. Did you know that Arizona has the largest shrimp farms in the United States?
Oh, really?
No shit. Yeah. Really?
Yeah, out in the middle of the high desert. You can see them when you fly over from North Phoenix or whatever.
You know, what I learned this week.
If you're eating shrimp, it's probably from fucking Arizona.
That's great. I was talking to your co-host Dave Matt. We were arranging your spot tonight, and it was raining. Yeah.
He's my agent.
Yeah, he is. He's your super agent, and so it's raining, and there's like the noise hitting my car, and he's like, "What the hell is that? Like, what's that noise going on? You have like a music machine or something in the background?" I was like, "No, it's rain. Do you even know what rain is?" And then he said, "No. Yeah, actually, it rains more here than it does in California." I was like, "Holy shit, really?"
Is that true?
That's what he said. I don't know. I mean, I don't believe anything I read on the internet.
I think he's just pulling your chain there.
I don't really. Oh, Matt, that's fucked up if you're doing that. That's not nice. I like learning new things, not fake things.
Wait. You take Matt at face value ever?
Sometimes I do. You know, I get confused with you guys. I think it rotates in who to trust the most. I think of the four of you, like if the four of you told me a statement and I had to believe one was true, whatever Jay said is what I would go with.
I was going to just say, yeah, it's probably Jay.
Yeah.
sounds pretty safe there.
Yeah. Dave, what's going on with you, man? What's new in Dave land? What's new in NFHC land? How's things in Arizona and with you?
Things are, okay, I guess. We got some serious COVID flare-up stuff, so things are shutting down again, and now they're finally mandating masks, and... there's a bunch of people crying about it. It's pretty funny. So I relish people having bad times because that's the kind of person I am. Mm-hmm. And that, there's a lot of that going on. It's 106 today, I think. And, you know, usually I hate it, but I've moved into a place with a pool. So now I'm all about this joint. All the way up until a year ago, I didn't know what it was like to live with a pool in Arizona. And now I do. Yeah. So
now it's nice. You would think that the 106 degrees would kill the corona. So I don't know what's going on with you guys down there. We're doing great.
You
got to
shove a light bulb up your ass, right?
Yeah. I'm sorry, Ray. Were you saying something? I interrupted you. Is my delay bad again tonight?
Yeah, maybe. I was just saying this. You got a pool during most of the year, and it's a hot tub during the summer.
No, actually, I mean, the aerator does a really good job. Just circulate the air, the water at night, and do that little sprinkler thing. It works great.
Wow. Fantastic. All right. So, you know, Ray, we got a lot of fun stuff planned tonight. All right. And I don't want to get too far into it. But last week we made big waves with our stories, my stories. Of what happened with Marconin and the accusations against him and everybody turned their backs on him. And I said last week that I did reach out and email him. I did get a response. I did receive a response from him. And he said, "Hey, you're the last person I expected to hear from." And that's really, really much to say. You know, something happened, but not the way that it's been told. So again, I'll send him another email. But listen, Marconin, if you're listening to this, I doubt you are, but if you are, you have a free and open space on this show to come on and tell your side of the story. And you don't have to. All right. I'm just putting out there because everybody seems to have turned their back on you. I'm still here because I got what do I care? Right. Right. What do I give a shit?
You're in the basement. What's the matter?
Yeah. That's, but it's just, it's funny. It's funny that, the podcast that I used to do, that was about giving advice to players about how to be better people and mental health and also all this fancy shit that we did. Still is hosting all 176 or so episodes of Marconin, who is now an accused sexual predator whose friend Jules turned her back on. But I guess she doesn't necessarily believe that he was bad enough to pull those episodes off their feeds. I don't know. That's kind of weird for her to be silent. Dave, if it turned out that like Dylan had been credibly accused of some type of sexual deviance, to the point where he had to leave the internet, Would you guys still keep his episodes of NFHC still posted, or would you take them
down? Yeah, see, so there's 135 of them, and that's all of them. So I think we probably have to. The disclaimer or something? I don't know how that would work.
Yeah, but
I don't know. First of all, I'd wait, you know. I'd wait until things happened. Just because somebody says something doesn't mean it's true. I know.
Oh.
Jump down my throat, but I'd wait to see how it played out first. So now, Marconin, I did read a little bit about this. He was like, is a big World of Warcraft guy, yeah? He was server first for a couple of things, and no?
He became somebody because of me, and bringing him on to Torn Think Tank with the bits that we produced together. And then he took my chair. So he was actually, you know, and that was a big show. So he was, you know, a pretty well-known member of the quote-unquote community. And the second an accusation of consensual, of a relationship that was very consensual, came out, everybody turned their back on him. Every single person. Actually, no, I can't. That's not true. There have been people who have reached out to me through private messages or through Discord or whatever to let me know that, you know, hey, you know, this kind of seems weird. Thank you for speaking up. You know, it's too hard to even say anything because this community is so vicious and they'll turn your backs on you if you don't agree with the mob mentality. So you're right. Everybody should wait and listen to both sides of the story. But no, we have to believe without evidence. And we have to kick people immediately.
83%.
Because we don't hurt anybody.
That's what I hear.
Yeah, well, I agree with Matt. We should believe 83%. So, but you know, in the Warcraft community, they believe 100% of the time without evidence. And they even went so far as the big Convert to Raid guild, their leader, Pat Crane, had when he issued his statement removing Marconin from their guild, it wasn't enough. It wasn't enough. Affair, it wasn't harsh enough. Yeah. You didn't name him. How dare you not name him? But then he had to issue correction. You're right. I didn't name him. His name was Marconin. And then
without
the biggest revelation.
And it was still wasn't enough?
It's never enough. Never apologize. Never apologize on the internet because it's never enough. But one of the bigger revelations, Ray, we were talking about this, but is that you know, Jules who left and moved to Minnesota to work with Pat Crane. Is no longer friends with him and hasn't been for 2 years. And that's the time since he moved to California, I believe. So that was super interesting to learn about. You guys, I know I sound like an asshole and I'm sorry for it. And Dave, I'm sorry to drag you into this, buddy. I just have to get all this out because, you know, it's my podcast, deal with it. But
get it.
Yeah. Jules is a phony and a fraud. And if she believed a word she said, those episodes of Torn Think Tank with Marconin would have come down last week. Immediately, but she's just playing up for points for that stupid community that's all she has. And that podcast is all she has because what else? She doesn't have any other podcast right now. That Jules and Coffee Hour nobody listened to that. And fucking the Torn Think Tank is all she has. So if she pulls down 176 episodes of Marconin, Ray, how many does she have left with me? Oh, wait, 114. So I'm still there.
So we're you guys are at 114 tonight, Rich Dickman is?
Yeah.
Yes, wow. Yes, sir. Yeah.
So that's why this is as far as you've ever gotten in life.
Yeah. This is my mea culpa, one might say. Yeah. So I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. Tonight, after the show, Ray might say to me, hey, Rem, you were a little too harsh on Randy. I need you to apologize to him. And then I'll apologize to Randy and not mean it. And then Randy will write back and with all these vicious, horrible things he's always wanted to say to me, accusing me of being in love with Ray. And I'll have to leave this show. I did clip. Well, my computer went to shit. I had to rebuild the whole thing. Dave, you'd be proud of me. I had to remove a hard drive and install a new hard drive and reinstall Windows. I all by myself. Thank you, buddy. No thanks to ass producer Chris, by the way, Ray. All right. You saw what an asshole he is. I'm glad we call him ass producer Chris because he was working from home this week. And I said, hey, man, my computer's not working. Can you take a look at it? Well, I'm working. Like, fuck you. You're working. You work from home. Shut up. So I FaceTimed with him. We took my computer apart and everything was intact. So we figured the hard drive was bad. So I said, hey, can I drop it off and maybe you can take a look at it tonight? So he looked at it overnight and he lost four screws. You know, the screws you put in the bottom to keep the shit together? He lost four screws.
I gain screws every time I take my laptop apart.
He lost four. And he didn't do shit. And so he said, go to Best Buy and pick up an M2 SSD for a laptop. And I said, okay. So I went to Best Buy. I picked up an M2 SSD for a laptop. I took a picture of it and I showed it to him. And he's like, I don't know if that's going to work. So I called him while he was working and he says, what? And I'm like, dude, I bought exactly what you told me to buy. Oh, okay. It'll work fine. And then he was all busy and he was all angry and stuff. And, oh, I think he just texted me. Let's see. Nope. Oh, yeah. He texted me about the screws. That's hilarious. that's four. So then he was all pissed off and like I was bothering him while he was working. So then I told my wife, I said, listen, you're down there. You're picking up the kids. Can you grab my laptop and just see if he has like a Windows key and I can just reinstall. I'll just do it myself. I'll figure it out. And then it's like, well, she says to me, he's working. So I'm working. I work all the time and you're constantly bothering me for bullshit. So go fucking knock on his door and get my goddamn computer from him. Okay. So that,
yeah, but what do you do versus what does he do? What if he does something important and you don't?
No, I do stuff way more important than he is, Dave. Yeah, I can't talk about it on the air.
He's an ass producer.
Yeah. He produces ass. Yeah.
Yeah. He's just about to get the producer revoked. So he'll just be an ass.
Yeah, because in my time of need, he wasn't there. But Ray and Matt were. So, excuse me. Big shout out to Ray and to Matt. Scatty Matty, buddy. Thank you. Appreciate you guys. Just keep my head level. All right. So, that's done. Dave, you're going to love this. We're going to go to September 6th, 2014. And we're going to listen to the moment that Triple T ended. Okay? With me, anyways. All right? Because what led to all this was Jules' stupid husband. He was on a podcast the night before, and we were doing our drunken liquor fueled that night as well. And we decided we were going to go crash the party and go visit him. And he looked like an idiot, and I was making fun of him. You ready for this, Ray?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, yeah.
This is fun. All right.
I think we're done.
Actually, I want to toss in one more thing. Holy crap. Want to check out Azeroth Roundtable that recorded last night, Arcane was their guest. So you can check him out. He did a little discussion about the favorite cities in WoW and all those great things. So yeah, Azeroth Roundtable with Ben and John and Arcane.
We tried to crash your chat room last night.
Yeah, you jerks.
Well, we wanted to see Arcane.
I know, right?
You've never seen him on a podcast. You should have seen him sitting up all straight and proper.
Yeah, well, it's his first podcast appearance. Good go, Arcane.
You need to give him more microphone lessons. Because he was kind of the side of it. He wasn't talking directly into it. And you have a directional mic there.
I do have a directional mic. He'll get used to it.
He needs to put his lips right on top of that thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Whoa. Yeah, he wasn't doing that.
I'm listening.
So you should talk to him.
I'll talk to him. No worries.
All right, it drove me crazy.
Jerk.
I wanted to yell.
All right.
Jules, let's bring it home.
Bring the baby home already.
Special thing.
Okay, so that you can hear.
That was your last words on that podcast?
No, there's a couple more. There's a couple more. Oh, okay. I just want to point out where I'm mentioning. You know, this is what led to the emails and the breakup. All right. But you could hear it, right? You could hear how annoyed she was.
A little tension, yeah.
A little bit. Yeah. All right. Here's some more.
Thanks, as always, to Arcane, the celebrity guest for Azeroth Roundtable. I guess he's a celebrity now. I love Arcane. Oh, my God. He was not excited to see me when I jumped into Mumble the other night. He was not excited for me to be there. And I'm like, hey, Kane. And he ignored me for 10 minutes. And I was like, hey, Kane, how are you? I heard you're going to be a guest on Friday. And he's like, hey, Reb, how are you? And like, that was it.
Because you're a jerk to him like all the time.
Well, that's what he gets. So for Jewel.
All right. And so finally, the absolute final words I ever said on Triple T. Here it is.
For Kane, for me, until next time. Slash moo, everybody.
Slash moo.
Yeah, that's it. All right. So after that became, we need to do a pretty, okay. Go ahead, bud.
That was pretty not climactic. Like, I was expecting some fireworks, and you guys were all just like, all right, see you next time.
Yeah.
And then there was no next time for you.
Yeah.
Because she was not about getting into that stuff on the show. So it was after. And it was, hey, you're kind of being a little rough on my husband. And maybe you should just write him an email and apologize. Yeah, okay, no problem. All right. Hey, later tonight, Ray, we're recording a bonus episode. Guess what emails are getting read?
That's right. Oh, it's going to be good.
Spicy.
All right. All right, that's enough of that. That's, if you have any thoughts you want to yell at me, it's richdickmanshow@gmail.com. So bring it. All right, Dave, you're a big fan of the show. And I know you listen
huge,
every week.
Massive. Yeah,
huge. Absolutely. And, mm-hmm. and I'm a big fan of your show as well. And I know that you like being a part of our weekly segments. So I brought a bunch of...
Still the last ones. You motherfucker. Yeah, go ahead. Sorry.
We got our regular weekly segments are back, Dave. And so we hope you'll be a part of this. What is this last thing I recorded? Oh, that's right. I got it. All right. Ray, let's do we have a bumper for our weekly segments? We don't, do we? I guess we do them all the time.
I think we just go into them.
Yeah, all right.
And now it's time for that weekly segment where we play fart sounds. Thanks for listening.
Jesus Christ.
It's dry.
All right. All right, Dave. Hey, Dave, let me ask you.
That was beautiful.
Yeah, thanks.
I feel right at home here now. I appreciate you.
As a fellow weak chin person, what do you do to accentuate your weak chin and show people that, you know, you are a real man?
I am a real man, and I grew a beard about it.
Yeah. Okay. Great. Because that's what I did. I grew one of those little beards that's not really a beard, but it looks like one. So it just
like
looks
a patchy,
like just
weird Irish guy beard or something.
Yeah. 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 So, oh my God, is that spaghetti?
So is that like?
Oh, shit.
So is that like how you cover up? So my. Like people wear baggy pants. Does that mean they're covering up as well?
Yeah, the fupa.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The fat upper penis yeah. area.
Yep.
Or pussy, depending or pussy on area. Who you are. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Let's move on to our next one.
We're back with everyone's favorite weekly segment. What color is your cock?
It's red. I saw a red one this week out here in farmland. Dave, what color is your cock?
It's like an off-white. It's an Italian guy penis, so, you know. I'm cut. Yeah,
penis. What are you
I miss my foreskin.
About?
I don't know about you guys, but Jesus.
Who's talking about penises here? This is rooster country, man. Got it, Ray.
Oh, yeah. So I don't have one of those. I'm just equating what I know. Extrapolating the data, as it were.
Mine was red and black until I killed it. And I told that story on the podcast a little while ago, but it was red and black.
Wring its neck.
And vicious.
Yeah.
Yep.
Are you out in farmland? You got like multiple cocks out there, or just the one that you killed?
I've got lots of cocks out here. I mean, yeah, chickens
are
big
multiple,
business.
They fight.
Yeah. Yeah. And out here, it's like fake farmland where people think they're farmers because they have chickens and cocks. So, you know, there's a bunch. Yeah.
Dave.
I think I learned this about you last time we spoke, but it was confirmed this evening, but you are Sicilian.
That is true.
Yeah. Ooh, what part
I'm
of the Sicily?
Mostly Southern Italian.
Yeah. Okay. You don't look it.
And I only know this because of the 23andMe. I was adopted. Okay. So like, and it was like one of those private lawyer adoptions and shit. And I didn't know. And somebody bought me a 23andMe a couple of Christmases ago. And I found out I'm like 38% Italian and like 20% Greek, and then the rest of it's, you know, under like 15 or 12 or whatever.
So you got a lot of Mediterranean in you, bud. Do you, are
I
you
do,
into
I do.
Like some Mediterranean food, or are you just?
I do. I love hummus. I love. I mean, I do. I didn't know why, but now I guess I do know why, and it's because that's where I'm from. And I tell you what was that scene in True Romance? We're eggplants, right? No, we're oh gosh, I did not think this one out. Anybody seen that True Romance? Nobody? No?
No,
I have not.
Oh, yeah, I know Spaghetti hasn't because he's like 12. We can't talk about his cock. Jesus Christ.
I mean, he might be raising chickens in Missouri. I mean, you don't know for sure. No.
I like that guy.
Hey, what's your favorite thing about spaghetti?
It's a good delivery system for marinara.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
I like that he conned us into making him our intern and then disappeared forever after that. So, you know, we spent a lot of time making him our intern.
I played a bunch of Sea of Thieves with him the last couple of weeks. That's been fun.
Yeah. Nice.
Maybe I can try that. He's a good cannoneer.
Ray, have you ever played Sea of Thieves, Ray?
I have not, but I've seen people play it briefly. Yeah. It looks like it's pretty fun. You know.
I love it because there's no like gauges. It's not like you have to like look up at the sails to see which way the wind's blowing, and you have to it's good stuff. And you have to communicate. Yeah. You playing have to communicate. If you do it by yourself, you're just not going to have any fun.
Interesting. That sounds fun.
All right. Let's move on.
It's the return of everyone's favorite weekly segment. What is the best 90s style?
Oh, man, I love this one. It's the same answer as last week, Ray. I love the, I like the flannel shirt over the t-shirt with the jeans. That's my favorite. I still do that today. I still rock that 90s style. What about you, Ray?
We'll get to Dave last.
I'd say frosted tips. It's all about the frosted tips, baby.
The Zach Morris style.
It's timeless. It's classic. You know, as soon as you see it, you know exactly what era that came from. One of a kind.
Right. Dave, what's your favorite 90s style?
You took mine. That was me. I was the flannel and the t-shirt and the baggy pants and the skateboard and all that. But
that's timeless, yeah.
I'm going to go with Z Cavaricci and the hammer pants.
Oh, there you go. Oh, God. Early 90s. You're going, that's
hammer time.
Yeah. Baggy clothes and bright colors. Nice. Okay. Uh-huh.
Bright colors is the second for me.
I had a wardrobe full of Z Cavaricci.
Oh, my cousin, the Italian Stallion.
Fantastic.
He was into all that too. So he also had a closet full of his parachute pants, as we called them. And I don't think
the
I
most
saw
ridiculous
him
pleated pants. I mean, they were the biggest pleats you've ever seen in your entire life.
Ridiculous.
I didn't really go for the colors. I went for more like the grays and the blacks and stuff or whatever, but I went for that style.
Yeah.
Like the shape and everything.
Dave, were you playing in bands in the 90s?
At the very end though.
Yeah.
Like 98, 97, 98, 99.
What kind of bands were you listening
to? That was all crust punk. That was all like the dirtiest punk rockers you ever thought of.
Yeah. All right. Did you like Godsmack?
No, and I didn't like you if you liked Godsmack.
I saw Godsmack live once because they were Breaking Benjamin opened for them, so I got to see. I ended up seeing Godsmack live, not on purpose, but it was fun. It's a good time. Me and producer Ryan. Yep. He was 15. I think he got his first whiff of weed at the concert. We were in the back row and the guys were sparking joints left and right.
Okay. Are concerts less full of like smoke these days because of the adaptability of everything else? No, but like everyone has edibles now. So does that reduce the amount of smoke at concerts? No. I haven't been to a concert in forever.
Yes, it's both weed, but it's two different things. If you want to get high right now, you smoke a joint. If you want to go to bed and sleep really well, you eat something. That doesn't kick in for like an hour or two.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm going to say no, it does not.
See, I've heard from my friend Ray, like just as Dave said, you know, you get higher quicker by... You got to tell your wife to stop coming because it's very distracting when she's back there in her shorts and her tank top getting clothes for everybody.
I'm so glad one of you guys is getting some ass. Yeah.
Good for you, buddy. Here's the next one.
We're back yet again with the segment known as Why is the song Take On Me the best song of the 80s?
You know, because it's a dance jam, right? You can dance to that and you can bob your head. You don't have to dance, but you can. It's very versatile. You can use it in different situations. Take On Me. Awesome song. Dave, what do you think?
Well, I mean, the video was iconic.
Yep.
You know, I mean, the hand-drawn thing. And I mean, there's been, probably a half a dozen pop culture references just to the video. And it is a great tune. I'm into that 80s shit.
Yeah.
Like, and they, even without it being the whole cultural, you know, mainstay, it's just a good song. I'm a music, you know, I do music, and from a simply objective standpoint, it's good. It's a good track.
Right. Yeah, I agree. It's that the song is very, very well done. And then especially the music video takes over the top. The way they blended the animation in, oh my goodness. You can watch that over and over and think that was something that was done recently because it's done so well.
Right.
You forget or don't realize, like someone like Spaghetti, I guarantee you he'd never know that was from the 80s other than us telling him right now.
Yeah. Well, the fact that we talk about it every week too. It's amazing how we find something new every week to talk about and take on me. So.
Yeah.
Hey, Dave. So that leads me to another question. Maybe you can help answer because you're an old man like me, a little bit older.
Yeah.
Why is 80s pornography so much better than anything we have today? You know what I'm talking about?
I'm going to have to disagree with you.
Oh, man.
Okay. I don't think it is. I like the advent of HD and pornography.
Yeah.
Maybe you don't because you're actually seeing what's there. But I mean, that lo-fi shit, I don't know. And the dicks with sideburns, I'm not into that. Mm-hmm. I don't know. And back in the 80s, we didn't know what the hell we was doing, really. I don't know.
Everybody was coked up.
I mean, you know, I hope we're about to take this past PG-13, but I really like seeing girls squirt when they come. So that ain't happening in the 80s. Like, I'm pretty sure dudes didn't even know where the clitoris was until 92. So yeah. Making
thanks
a girl come
away
was
my
like,
audience, asshole. Like, I'm trying to have like a welcome. nice conversation about wholesome, you know, the styles of pornography, wholesome pornography conversation.
Wholesome bit about pornography.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. See, that's the thing. It's the HD. Like, it's just not the same, right? Because it looks too good. I like that it's dirty and a little blurry and more natural, right? There's a lot more care involved rather than just like, you know, beating the shit out of each other with sex. There's more love. Oh my God, what is that noise? Ray, is that your house?
Yeah, but it's when it's more blurry, you get to use your imagination a little bit because you can't see every little detail.
Yeah.
And when you get to use your imagination and kind of fill in the blanks, it's just like Jaws, right? That was what made Jaws so great. You hear the dun, 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 but you never see everything, right? So it's that effect. Using your imagination just makes it that much better. And you fill it in how you want. And so everyone can watch the same thing and still get enjoyment out of it.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, so by your logic, Cloverfield's like the best movie that ever happened, right?
Yep. Absolutely.
Oh, I got so sick watching that movie. Oh, I was so motion sick. Oh, terrible.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah. God. You guys didn't get motion
VR?
Sick? Yeah, I don't do
VR.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, that should be a bonus episode. Ray does VR and vomits. I'm sorry. Rem does VR and vomits. We should totally.
I have one of those little VR headsets that came with a Samsung phone one time.
You slide your phone in.
I can send that to you. Yeah, slide your phone in. The obviously the quality, because the screen, you literally have your face like right next to the screen, right? So obviously the phone pixels, the resolution's not that high, so it's a little fuzzy, but yeah, I mean it's still tricky.
You get
Rem
sick?
Yeah, it could do it, yeah. Yeah, it's freaked people out. I put it on other people and they tripped out.
Oh, yeah. Like, I can't do first person shooters
type thing.
I tried playing like Half-Life 2 once, and like I was ready to throw up afterwards. I couldn't do it.
But you can do World of Warcraft just fine, which is
third person. Yeah.
No, you got an anchor. Is that what it is? Is that what you're going to fucking say?
Yeah.
You knew.
No, that's not what I'm going to say. That's what it is, Dave. Jesus Christ. I mean, get off my back, man. Goddamn.
Hey, you asked me
and
here.
And now, it's time for the weekly segment we like to call...
What the fuck happened to my voice?
It's funny we do this every week, and it's always something that comes up that, I got to go back to your co-host, Matt. He was actually listening to episode 4 of Torn Think Tank for some reason, and he texted me, and said, hey, it's baby Rem voice. I'm like, oh, shit. Yeah, how terrible those old episodes were. Yeah. Dave, what happened to your voice? Was it the cigarettes?
Yes. Well, I mean, cigarettes and weed and I've sounded like this since I was 11, so I don't know.
Oh, goddamn.
I was this tall and this build and had the same body hair since I was like hit puberty. Right then and there. Oh. Bam, one day.
How tall are you?
5'9".
Oh shit, I'm taller than you. Man. I'm 5'10". Fuck you, Dave.
That's fine. Grow a beard. Then we'll talk.
Fuck. God damn it. Ray, how tall are you, bud?
5'9", 5'10", somewhere in that range.
Holy shit. I don't know exactly.
I haven't measured myself in a while.
Well, how tall are you?
Probably 5'9" and a half, right between you two.
Yeah.
Ooh, I like the sound of this.
Oh, no. Wait, hold on.
Yeah, yes, let's keep going. It's a Ray sandwich.
And now it's time for that weekly segment where we ask you, who would you rather pay? Rem, Ray, or this week's guest?
Yep, there we go. All right, Dave, who is it?
Well, I fuck myself all the time. I'm used to it, so me.
You got to get a little strange, though, man. So you gotta pick.
Well, I mean, so Ray looks just like my childhood friend, best friend Roger growing up, so that would just be too fucking weird. Yeah, and with a jaw like yours, I'm pretty sure you've got a really high gag reflex. So ain't neither one of you guys going to make me come. Yeah. Therefore, it's me. It's all about me.
I'm going Dave because extra holes.
Ooh, I do have extra holes. Anybody curious? You want to see?
Of course.
I'll throw down my vote as Dave as well. For
Look at that. Oh, shit.
Oh, look at that.
I made a both
Dave, say Dave just blew his face, his face hole. Thanks for sharing, man. I appreciate it.
That's awesome.
I'm sorry, Ray. Go ahead.
That was pretty much. Yeah, that's what I was going to say, Dave. Because you know, you gotta try the spicy stuff every once in a while.
Yeah, you always need something.
I'll make you come so good, girl.
Yeah,
Dave. How did you know that? Like, I have I have a horrible gag reflex because of my chin. Is that a thing? Is that like a scientific thing?
Yes.
Is it really?
No, I mean, my own scientific research. I'm not peer reviewed or released. This is just what I've learned in, you know, my career.
Yeah, because I do choke on things fairly easily, right? It's embarrassing.
Let's see if you get past this episode, huh?
Yeah, we'll see.
And now it's time for that weekly segment where we discuss, what did you cook in your Instant Pot this week?
I love this one. I've done so much Instant Pot cooking this week, you guys. I did mm-hmm. mashed cauliflower. I did chicken tacos. Ooh, I did shit. I did another thing too. I can't remember now. Holy shit! Oh, I did stuffed artichokes. I used it like 3 or 4 times. It's been a big Instant Pot week, so we've had several meals that way. Dave, what are you cooking in your Instant Pot?
I'm sad to say I haven't got one yet.
Oh shit!
My dad has one, and we cooked asparagus and corn on the cob in it at the same time, and they both came out perfect. So
that's amazing.
Yeah, that pretty much sold me, and I need to go do that.
Hmm. Ray, how about you, bud?
Can't go wrong. Well, I was supposed to cook some carnitas on Monday, or I tried to, and then I got around to it the next day, and it was apparently had a little bit of a smell to it, so wasn't able to. That fucking plan's shot. I was ready to do it just because I don't give a flying rat's ass. I mean, you put it in there, it's supposed to cook. It doesn't smell bad to me, but apparently maybe it would make some people's tum-tums hurt. So, you know, we didn't make it. We didn't make the carnitas.
Oh, my
So I didn't cook anything. I did make ground beef tacos a couple times. I ate 24 tacos in the last 2 days. There's 3 tacos.
Not that big. 4 or 5. I had 5 tacos in the last 48 hours.
Well, I mean, there's a taco store like right around the corner from you,
Del
Dave,
Taco.
Yeah, lots of tacos.
Yeah, we got good Mexican food here too.
Yeah.
You know, I'm a late convert to Mexican food. When I did the show earlier on with Huel, I would tell him how Mexican food was terrible, but I'm all about it now. Like, I went to some decent Mexican restaurants and I'm sold. I'm down. So good for Viva la
good
Mexico.
Mexican food. Like authentic. Yeah.
America's favorite, Taco Bell. Best Mexican food place there is. Best Mexican
food in the country. Dave, so Ray's wife is Mexican. To die I don't for. Know if you knew that.
Sweet. She got a mustache?
Yeah, of course.
She wears a sombrero all the time.
Yeah. Ray's 25% Chinese, so Ray's kids are like the best minority. They're Chinese Mexican.
That's it's like Tiger Woods, right? They play golf or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
You gotta teach
start
them.
Training them.
Get that little baby of yours, put a golf club in his hand.
Yeah.
All right, yeah. All right. Weekly segment, yada yada. What are you doing to fight gingivitis? And why does it have so many eyes in that damn word?
Every week. Dave, what are you doing to fight gingivitis?
It's so ridiculous.
I floss, not as often as I should, and I brush my teeth, and I have the anti-gingivitis Listerine stuff. The gold shit that everybody hates.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, the gold shit. You go hardcore with that. Nice.
Yeah.
Ray, how about you? What do you?
I don't like drinking mint.
Yeah, nah. You know, a little too strong. Yeah. Ray, how are you fighting your gingivitis?
Just brushing and some sort of mouthwash. It's supposed to, it says something about gingivitis on it, you know, it works, does the trick.
Right. See, I can't live without no antiseptic flossing. Mouthwash. No floss. I don't floss either. Okay. Only when I eat corn or ribs when I floss.
Yeah. If you got
floss your butthole.
Yeah.
Welcome to the show. Sorry.
What's better than Guy Fieri? Yep. A weekly segment to talk about him. On your marks, get set, go.
My favorite. Dave, I'm going to let you start. Why is Guy Fieri so great?
There's a restaurant down the street from us called Chino Bandito, and they were featured on one of his shows. I don't remember what show it was, and that's how I found the place. I didn't ever even know the place existed. And I heard about it on his show, and it was like 2 miles from my house. And it is the best. It's Mexican and Chinese fusion. And
oh my God, that's Ray's kids.
I can buy that place up in a heartbeat.
They got fucking the best jerk fried rice there is. It's delicious, which is Jamaican. So I don't know, whatever.
Wow. Wow, that's so much going on.
Identity
there.
Crisis.
Yeah,
and if you Photoshop a guitar into Guy Fieri's hands, he looks like he's in NoFX. Those are my Guy Fieri stories.
Or Sum 41, maybe.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Ray, what's great about Guy Fieri this week?
I mean, you know what? Let's bring it back to another weekly segment: Frosted Tips. All about the Frosted Tips.
Yeah.
You just, Frosted Tips left, right, up and down, I'm every way, I'm all for them.
Yeah.
You can't lose.
You know, this week I want to talk about Guy's Ranch. Guy's Ranch. Shit,
Flavortown?
The name of the. No, Flavortown Ranch. He's got a show, Guy Fieri. It's a ranch, it's a show where he cooks outside with his friends. Like, he has a whole, it is home, he has an outdoor kitchen, and he brings other cooks over, and they all make a meal together. And so he just stands there. While all like the four or five other cooks are like working their asses off to make food, and he just walks between them, and he's like, "Hey, Sean Waxman, what are you making this week?" And he's like, "Oh, I've got lamb. I'm grilling it and crusting it with salt." And then he walks over and says, "Alex Guarnaschelli, what are you making right now?" She's like, "Well, first I'm going to make some balsamic tomato salad, and then we're going to make a little dessert with a little gelato and some champagne." And then he walks around to, "Hey, Robert Warner, what are you making?" He's like, "Well, I'm making an Asian fusion Mexican dish, like for Dave and Ray's kids, and it's great." And yeah, and then Guy just he arbitrarily chooses a winner at the end, and it's amazing. I love that guy.
Does he actually cook? I don't think I've ever seen him cook.
No, he doesn't. He just eats.
Yeah, exactly. He had a show, Guy's Big Bite, but nobody watched it. But he was more entertaining going to talk to other people like me. And so they gave him a show.
You're like, not good at what you do. Yeah. You just got to go watch somebody else do it.
That's right. And then you got to tell them, you got to pretend like you know the techniques. So you can say, oh, man, I can taste the pepper in that. Oh, my gosh. Mm-hmm. Bang. Yeah. Oh, yep. That's a... Downtown the flavor.
You watched him put an ingredient in. You just write down ingredients they put in on your little notepad. And then when you take a bite, you reference your notepad.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I can really taste the cayenne.
Taste the cardamom. Mm-hmm. All right, we got we got a couple. Dave, you know how these goes. We only have a few more left. All right, so but we're getting there. Every week we do these, so I know you know what's coming.
Yeah. And now it's time for that weekly segment where we discuss what's your favorite lyric from Pepper by Butthole Surfers.
Oh, God, it changes every week.
How's that
Dave,
go?
Yeah, how's that I don't mind on? The sun. Sometimes.
Somebody sing me the chorus.
Hold on, I'll bring it up on YouTube. Ray, you start talking, and I'll
get
ready for
I don't mind
for
the sun sometimes.
Sometimes, but the image as it shows.
Yeah.
I'm going to go with I don't know because I don't really like... I mean, I like Butthole Surfers, but I really hated the new stuff. And but I did see that guy get hit in the face with a water balloon on stage once, and then he got real mad and walked off. That was at Lollapalooza in 96, I think.
Wow. Oh, you have a water balloon.
Yeah,
oh,
great.
My God, Dave. I have a story, too. I'll get to it. So you don't really have a favorite lyric?
Marky got with Sharon, and Sharon got Sharon. She was sharing Sharon's outlook on the topic of disease. Marky had a facial scar, and Bobby was a racist.
So it's funny you
Bobby was a racist?
Yeah,
is that what he says?
Racist. Yeah, you could say that stuff back in the 90s. It was okay.
But did he race cars or motorcycles? I don't...
He was a football player racist.
They were all in love with dying.
Oh.
They were doing it in Texas. Tommy played piano like a kid out in the rain. And then he lost his leg in Dallas. He was dancing with the train. They were all in love with dying. They were drinking from a fountain that was pouring like an avalanche coming down the mountain.
Coming down the mountain.
I don't mind the sun sometimes. The images it shows. I can
you so forth.
You on my lips and
Ray, I gotta stop this because we're gonna get copyright strike and we won't be able to make any money. Not that we do, anyways. I was at the they had the alternative radio station out here in 1996. It's called Radio 104, and they had the first ever Radio 104 Fest. And there was I won tickets to go to that with Fit actually, Ray, and that's actually where we saw our first boobs. A lady got up on a guy's shoulders and took her top off right in front of us. That was exciting. Yeah. So we went to the show, and it was a big music festival. All sorts of bands, like the Refreshments, were there, and I missed them because Fit was messing with his girlfriend on the roller coaster. But Everclear, there was Candlebox closed the show. There's a couple other bands I can't really name off the top of my head, but there was this one band I won tickets for. Dave, have you ever heard of Luscious Jackson?
I have not. No.
No. Okay.
At least not cognitively. So,
yeah, I couldn't tell you anything about them. All I know is they had a song, and I can't remember the name of it, but that's how I won the tickets. I won the tickets by calling in at the Luscious Jackson song. Okay, so Luscious Jackson is doing their set, and I decided that because I won tickets with their song, I needed to go watch them play. So we're up there watching Luscious Jackson play, and there's soda bottles, and people, the plastic ones, and people are just throwing them back and forth in the crowd, all right? Because everybody, it's the middle afternoon, everybody's hot and tired, they're just throwing things, having fun. And these bottles start going up towards the stage, and they start hitting the band members of Luscious Jackson. So at some point, they get fed up, all right? The microphones are off, and you just see like the instruments being thrown to the ground, and everybody walking off stage. And then one of the members of Luscious Jackson comes back out, and the microphone's off, so you don't hear anything. But all you hear is, "You guys ruined it. Fuck you." And she gave us all the finger, and she left.
Oh,
and everybody's
wow.
standing around in stunned silence. Like, nobody's like, "Oh, my God, what happened?" Right? It's quiet. And I look around, and 16-year-old Rem throws his middle fingers in the air and says, "Fuck you." And I just start screaming it. And everybody around me, we get the "fuck you" chant going, "Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you." Yeah. So that was my
ACAB, guess. Right?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, it's not that kind of show. Sorry.
No, it's fine. That's it. That's my Luscious Jackson story.
It was a very similar story when I saw the Butthole Surfers. They were. It was hot, and it was like 4 o'clock in the afternoon in Phoenix in the middle of the summer, 110 probably. And he stopped the song. He's like, you guys better fucking knock it off. You guys keep throwing shit. We're gonna quit. And they kept throwing shit. But he started playing whatever song it was, and he got fucking nailed right in the face with a giant water balloon. And he got so mad and stormed off stage. And the rest of the guys were like just kind of playing still. And they're like, "Eh, fuck it." And then they just like took their guitars off and dropped them on the ground and walked off.
Oh, where does anyone even get a water balloon?
Back in the 90s, you could do
anything
you wanted.
Oh, yeah.
I think I hopped the fence for that show.
Wow.
Oh, that's amazing.
I miss the 90s. You know, 80s me music too. Is great, and 80s porn was better, but in the 90s, you can't beat the 90s. It's great.
Well, that's
great
when I got time. Into shit, you know? That's when, yeah. That's my time. That's when I was growing up.
That's yeah. Like, that's our time. Dave, you and I are Sicilian well, blood dude. Brothers, man.
That's right.
Man.
Yeah, Ray.
Class of 98.
I feel so excluded.
No shit. Dave, I was class of 98 what are you too. Like?
What are you like? 28? 30?
What? I'm 39.
Come on, how old are you?
Who, me?
No, not Ram. Ray.
Oh. No, I'm 35.
Oh, okay. Well, you look young. So good.
That's
good
I hear you. That. Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess I can't complain. The older you get, you hear that, you complain less. When you're like 18 and 20 and you hear that, you're like, shut up.
I'm going to make Dave's old. Day. Dave, how old do you think Ray's wife is?
She's probably older. I'm going to say she's older.
Mm-mm.
39.
Oh, God. No, Ray. No. Ray doesn't mess around. 10 years younger than that, Dave.
So she's 5 years younger than you? 4 years Six. Younger than you? How old is she? I hate
29.
Math.
29? She's 29.
Good for you. Here's the question, though. Does she suck? Like, not in the literal way. Is she okay as a wife?
Is she pain in the ass?
Oh, yes.
All right, absolutely. Then. Good for you.
Well, yeah. I mean, that's kind of a trick question, right? Because the answer is always, yeah, they're all pains in the ass.
Yeah.
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 Oh, they're just the worst. All right, there you go.
And now it's time for that weekly segment where once again we talk about who's your favorite transgender porn star.
Hang on, let me Google some.
Ray, is it the same as last week?
Yeah, same as last week. I've never watched porn, so I don't know any still. One of these days, I'll actually watch some porn, and then I'll be able to answer this. And it'll probably start with transgender porn, just so that I can address this weekly segment, you know, with an actual answer. But, you know, up until this point, I don't know any.
Yeah.
Who's yours this week?
Dave, you look like you have an answer. Are you ready to go?
Oh, yeah.
I've only looked at four so far, but I'm going to say Foxy with two X's.
Yeah. Okay. Foxy's done a lot with non-trans women. So, you know, she's crossover. So that's cool. You know, I'm gonna stick with last week's answer, Ray. It's Bailey J. Mm-hmm. Right? Because you know, I really appreciate the art of being a transgender female and making yourself look like a woman, and the beauty that they have in their faces and their eyes and their bodies and the care they take to do so. So, and Bailey J does a wonderful job. So that's my answer again this week.
Yeah. That's like 3 out of 5 or 3 out of 6 weeks in a row or not in a row, but you know,
we do
a good
a
answer.
Okay. Oh,
I mean, okay. She bad. I mean, fuck whatever her pronoun is.
Yeah. It's all good. That's a shame. Don't be like that, Ray. Stop laughing. God damn. Oh, boy. What's this one?
It was the way you said it, Dave, was hysterical.
Thank you. I like that. That's what I'm here for. I'm the talent.
Ah, fuck it. Let's do another weekly segment. Have you ever drank your own piss?
No, the answer is still no. The answer is still. Dave, you ever had to drink your own pee?
That's a hard no.
Yeah, hard no. Okay. Ray? Uh-oh. You can't smell, so you probably have.
Get the Rona?
I have not, but the temperatures have exceeded 100 degrees around here a lot lately. There's a couple times where I was out in the sun. I was getting dehydrated. I was getting close, but no. Still no.
Still no. Yeah, no.
Maybe,
no, Dave,
maybe next week.
Ray was born with a genetic condition where he cannot smell. He has no sense of smell.
You lucky son of a bitch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's amazing. You can't Never smell other people's to. Shit. That's amazing.
Yeah.
So somebody the other day said something along the lines of, man, it's going to be so great when they develop a surgery to give you your sense of smell. And I was like, yeah, I don't think I want it.
Good on you.
Because here's how I think smell works, because this is how people talk about it. Everyone says, that smells like shit. Oh, that's terrible. Oh, this is bad. Oh, this is, who smells?
Yeah, it's like 2 out of 10 is like, oh, that smells good.
Yeah, and rarely does someone go, yeah, it smells really good. What is that? Right? So I'm like, yeah, maybe I don't want to smell.
Yeah. All right. We're getting to the end of it, Dave. So hang tight. We're almost there. You know how this is. You listen every week. So.
I do.
And now it's time for this week's weekly segment. Oh, shit. What's your favorite strain of weed?
Oh, man. We talked about this, all right? I don't know why we have to keep doing this every week. Well, my friend Mike, all right, because I don't smoke this stuff ever, but my friend Mike always tells me his favorite strain is Northern Lights. He's always, good one. Yeah. So, Ray, how about you, bud? We'll get to the pro in a second.
Yeah, well, just to touch on what you said, smoking, the only last time I smoked was when I was, I don't know, like 21 or 22. So, but since then, I don't know. I don't know anything about weed. I honestly, if Mr. Dickman could just get rid of the segment, because neither of us actually use it. So, I mean, it's kind of a fucking pointless.
Yeah,
pointless
it seems like a waste segment. Of time. You could be like generating some real content.
Right.
yeah. That sounds like a really good point right there. Let's bring that forth to Mr. Dickman. And hopefully we can get something changed.
When I talk to him next, I will. Dave, what's go ahead and answer the question. What's your favorite strain of cannabis?
Probably White Widow.
White Widow.
It's a indica. It's an older hybrid, it is a hybrid strain, but it's an indica and a little tiny, small little nuggets. Lots of crystals on it. It's good weed. Mm-hmm. Second backup is Blue Dream. Blue Dream is always a good standby.
Yeah. What do you think? Is Dylan a weed snob like yourself, or does he just smoke whatever's thrown in front
of him? Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, he absolutely is. Okay. And he can thank me for that.
What is he like? Is he same as you? Is he have his, does he like come to say, I mean, not to you, obviously, allegedly, you know, is he looking for like certain allegedly. Strains? Yeah.
Well, I mean, he's, It's not like he'd never done it before I met him, you know, but, you know, we've had discussions. He knows what he's talking about. He likes the good stuff.
Okay. All right. Well, that's good. You know, now that it's becoming legal more and more, you know, it's something, Ray, that you and I probably have to get more familiar with so we can have conversations with people.
We need to get educated.
Yeah. Yep. We're very, very ignorant on the subject. All right.
Smoke some fucking weed, guys. Jesus.
Two more.
And now it's time for the weekly segment where we find out how many times you've been accused of inappropriate sexual behavior today.
Oh, today?
Yeah, Dave, how many times have you been accused of inappropriate sexual behavior today?
None. Jesus Christ.
Ray?
Well, my wife already accused me of, I don't know, at least like half a dozen times. I mean, we only passed each other for, I don't know, half an hour today, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, but did you see what she was wearing?
That's pretty good for me.
She's asking for it.
Right? Yeah. That's one way of putting it.
What are you doing? You smacking her on the rear end as she walks by? Hey, baby, what's up? And doing that type of stuff?
Yeah,
or like,
yeah, you just got to get handsy. Just hands everywhere.
Nice. Yeah. All right. Well,
anywhere and everywhere.
I've been arguing with my wife the last 3 days, so I've not been accused of inappropriate behavior at all. So, boom, there you go. You know, not going to find my name on the internet. That's right.
Yet.
It's too bad.
Not today.
Yeah, too bad. All right. And our final weekly segment, plus the other ones we're doing tonight, but this is the final one. Uh-oh. Spaghetti's making signs. You can't read your goddamn sign, Spaghetti.
God damn it. Fuck off, Spaghetti.
No, it says Dave Grooms.
Holy fuck. I can't think of any more of these things. Oh, let's just play this one out. Fuck it. Yeah, go, segment. Go.
Dave, what's your favorite weekly segment?
The transgender porn star is probably my favorite. Because that made me learn something. I like learning things.
Yeah, cool. I'm glad we helped you learn.
Don't
something.
You guys have porn stars on often, or have a couple of times anyway?
Yeah,
yeah, we have. Yeah. But we're very good friends.
Not transgender though.
Yeah. Ray even won a dick contest.
Yeah. Nice. Good for you.
Just gotta,
yeah. Dave, yeah. You
against
you
who?
Have
you?
A, yeah, against me.
You said that in such a condescending way. that's like a slap to both of us, Rem. He's like, oh, yeah. Against you? As if like as if I could only beat you. Like, oh my god.
In real life he wouldn't have won.
There's a server mute button.
So there. God damn. Fucking Dave. Dave, you have a piercing in your penis, don't you?
I do, Prince Albert.
Can we talk about that? Like, first of all, I want to know why. Why did you decide to put a piece of hardware? Ooh, yeah,
I have
in
a question
penis?
Too.
I was actually talked into it. I was hanging out with a couple of dudes. They all worked at, one was a tattoo artist and one was a body piercer. And we used to hang out all the time, like at the shop. We all rode motorcycles and we'd go riding together and shit. I'd end up at their shop or their house or whatever. And like, Dick was his name, as funny as that is. he used to like, dude, let's fucking pierce that motherfucker. Come on, man. Fucking blah blah blah, and I did, and okay. I don't regret it. I'm glad I did it.
Where I've got
a 6-gauge captive bead in it.
So does it go like through the head of the penis? Like how does it? Like what?
It goes in through the urethra and then out through the bottom.
Oh Jesus Christ!
Yeah.
How? So what is it? So. All right, so what's the process here? The guy, like, you pull your pants down, the guy takes your dong in his hands, and he just shoves a needle through it, and, like, is that how that...
No, he uses a receiving tube, and he, like, puts it in your urethra, right? And it basically is just a tube that's bigger than the needle, and he kind of angles it and pushes it against, you know, itself or whatever, and runs a needle through it, and then pulls the tube out. And then runs a ring backwards through where the...
Jesus fucking Christ.
All right, so on a scale of 1 to 10, how bad did it hurt?
Well, I've had my nipples pierced before, and those were... The second nipple was hands down far more painful than the dick. And on top of it, like, the dick hurt, don't get me wrong, but the way it healed, because your own urine is sterile to your own wounds. So every time you peed, you cleaned it. And it wasn't a harsh, you know, like alcohol clean either. So the shit healed in literally, I was fucking again in like 7 days.
So I have heard of someone else that had that done. And they said that shortly thereafter, say they go to bed and the thing's obviously not healed. They go to bed, go to sleep at night. You know, your dreams start kicking in. You get a little wood going.
I caught a boner a couple of days afterwards and it wasn't comfortable. Okay. But the worst part was I rode a motorcycle almost everywhere I went. So that was tough. Matter of fact, I hurt myself on my motorcycle pretty bad like day three.
Yeah.
Probably stretched out the peeling time by a day or two. It was fucking rough.
You ever chip your tooth on it?
Not mine. No.
Do you change it out? Like, do you have different decorations for Christmas and Thanksgiving and shit, or is it the same one?
I have two, and I haven't changed this one out in, I don't know, years. Okay. I pull it out and clean it every once in a while, you know.
Yeah. Man. Okay. But
no, I mean, the other one I have is. It gets caught on things and shit like that. So I like the hoop because it doesn't get caught.
Do they make like cool designs? Like I knew a girl who had like a Captain America shield for her belly button piercing. Do they have that shit?
I'm sure they do.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm sure they do. I'm a pretty basic guy. I like stainless steel, I guess.
Now when someone sees it, what's their comment?
These days, it's not so... Back in the day, it was always like, what the fuck? Is that... Yes. Oh, my God. You know, it was a big deal. These days, it's fucking old hat.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Nothing shocks anybody
ever
anymore.
Lose out? Anyone ever walk away after they see it?
No.
Oh. Or is it more of a party time? Party time.
Yeah. especially as of recent, it's like, oh, shit, cool, all right. You know, they don't even, like, bat an eyelash.
Out there. Weird.
All right.
All right. I know what we got to do. We got to get your dick pierced.
Yeah, I know what we're doing this weekend. We got a 3-day weekend. We got plenty of time to heal up before.
Yeah, you go to the mall with your wife and kids to keep the kids in the car.
You go to Claire's Boutique and get a fucking.
Go to Claire's Boutique and walk in and be like, I'm here to get my dick pierced. And just watch all the heads turn. All the soccer moms like, what the fuck did you just say? Yeah, my dick.
Yeah, so make sure you're wearing a mask, motherfucker. All right, Dave, I come from a history of giving advice, a former podcast host of giving advice. And so we have a little segment here that pays homage to that. It's called Thinking With Your Dick, Man.
You want segments? We've got segments. It's Thinking With Your Dickman.
I love this one, Ray. All right, Ray, read the letter that we get. We get letters every week, people looking for advice, Dave. So we answer them as best we can. And we'd like you to partake.
So,
yeah. All right.
Yeah, yeah. So Jefferson writes in, hey, fellas, I'm 23 years old and dating a self-described liberated woman. Now, liberated woman's in quotes. Who has been on the pill for 2 years. Because it isn't covered by her insurance, and in her words, it's getting expensive, she wants me to share in half of the cost. My counter argument is that I still pay full price for all the condoms we use when having sex. What's your take?
I need to know things.
Why are they using condoms, Dave? Yeah.
If she's on the pill.
Are either of them 100% safe?
Well, no.
Maybe that's why. They're just being extra precautious.
Is she out getting some dick down from somewhere else?
Dave might be onto something here. All right. And last I knew, the liberals made contraception free all over the place. I'm sure she can get free birth control somewhere. Right, Dave? I mean, you have experience with this. You get birth control pills and Plan B for your chicks all the time.
I pay for them. I mean, the one Plan B I've had to buy, I bought. I mean, yeah. I left it in there for fuck's sake. Like, come on, of course I'm going to buy it. Jesus.
Yeah. All right. That's an honorable man right there. Ray, you don't have any experience in birth control. You have like 27 kids.
Yeah.
Pull out game week.
It's famous on the podcast. I've had sex 3 times with my wife. She's given birth to 5 kids. And yeah. That's all you need to know.
Wow.
Well, so let's
super fertile.
We can approach this a different way. Is that I've read that the birth control pill does things to women's chemistry that isn't all that natural or good for them. It kind of, you know, it leads to other health problems or makes them a little moody or a little crazy. The less that we can be on chemicals that change our chemical balance and change our personalities, the better. Right. So maybe there's alternatives here. What's his name? Jefferson? Jefferson. Maybe we can find some alternatives. Yeah. Like, number one, how about you practice abstinence? There you go. Be responsible. Practice abstinence. And then you don't have to worry about anything. You don't have to spend any money on condoms. You don't have to spend any money on birth control. You don't have to worry about any kids popping up because that's expensive. That's more expensive. Right. Or number two, one of you gets fixed. Right. We don't need any more kids in this world. You two don't sound like you're going to be great parents anyways. So just go ahead and get it.
Suck.
Yeah, just take care of it because you got that. Like that's what Huel did, right? Huel got
what about
it.
IUD.
That's number three. You know, we could do IUD because that's what's the effective rate of an IUD, Dave?
Well, in my experience, 100%.
There you go. In Dave's experience,
100%. I don't know exactly.
In your experience,
and that lasts what, 3 months? So,
are you kidding me? 5 years.
That's 5 years. Holy shit!
Yeah.
They got one that does 7 now. I think.
God damn!
I'll say this: there's an uncomfortable factor. When my wife had one in, I could feel it.
Yeah, sometimes you can.
When you're like,
when you turn it out.
Yeah.
It depends, and it can shift too. So there's, you know, it is what it is.
I tell you, hey, troubles.
If you don't want to have kids, you got to do weird shit.
Yeah. Otherwise, yeah, I would look into that, you know, going to Planned Parenthood to get into free birth control, Jefferson. I mean, that shit's easy. I mean, you're just being an asshole to writing to us and to putting your girlfriend on blast like this. Like, that's fucked up. That's unless she's like fucking around.
Yeah, spend less time having sex and more time working on your relationship.
Yeah.
What if the, how, what's how, one the like same, dude?
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, it's literally all. It sounds like he said he's 23 years old. That is the relationship.
Well, that he's still trying to figure out how to make a girl come. Yeah. So that's probably an issue.
Hey, if you're 23 years old, don't write us looking for sex advice, because you know what? Don't be stupid. Ray, get these things.
My best sex advice for you is be present and fucking try to make her feel good. All right.
Yeah.
And you'll enjoy yourself much more.
Good advice. Yeah.
Well, that's pretty deep, Dave. What else you got? Any more advice for young men?
No.
What about stay away from crazy chicks?
No, that's the best sex right there, dude.
Well, listen, it might be, but they'll fuck your life up. You know, they'll mess you up.
Don't come in them.
Well, no, I'm not.
Don't fucking come in them.
No, but if
then you're fine.
Listen, this is what I've been told.
Because at any point, you can walk away. If there's a child involved, there's like, you know, courts.
Well, hold on.
You know, if money.
Dave, you bring up a very valid question here, all right? Because at any point you can walk away. Sure. You can say that at 40, whatever you're now. I can say that at 39. Ray can say that at 35. But if you're 23, right, and you don't know any better, you're going to get stuck with this crazy chick. You're stuck, and maybe she's ruining her life, and she's calling you every 20 minutes saying she's going to kill herself if you leave. You know, that's a hard thing to do at a young age.
Yeah, but imagine how much harder it would be if there was a child involved.
Well, yeah.
So don't come in them. Don't come in the crazy ones.
Okay.
You'll be fine.
He'll use always
don't
say,
come in the smart ones either.
Yeah, don't don't come in. Put it on the curtains. All right.
We used to have a bit on our show where we asked all of our guests in or on.
Yeah.
And Ray is obviously an in kind of guy. Ram, you got kids?
I do.
Yeah, you're an in kind of guy.
Well, when I was asked that question, sure. I told Alan it's on the curtains because you don't want to get any, you don't want to make a mistake. Yeah.
Well, Ray, he's married to a Mexican girl. You got to go in the other room to come.
Yeah,
otherwise they get pregnant.
That's what I'm saying.
That's part of the joke I made too, and I could do it at the time because my co-host was a Mexican man, so I was able to make that joke. And I can't anymore. So actually, if you could delete that episode from NFHC, I believe it was 76. Unless Dane pulls a clip, fuck, God
matter,
damn it.
Matter of fact, we're going to put it behind a paywall and advertise it.
Oh. Ray, is this a Mr. Porno Man? Did we get a Mr. Porno Man letter?
We did, yeah.
Oh, like Jesus Christ. Okay. Dave, let me ask you, because you're a guest, and we're winding down here. We can do Dick of the Week, or we can do a Mr. Porno Man porn review.
Mr. Porno Man porn review.
God damn it. I fucking hate Mr. Porno Man.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, I chose wisely.
Son of a bitch. Oh, wait. Ray, I don't have, because my hard drive failed, I don't have Mr. Porno Man bumper. Is it in Dropbox, Ray?
Just play. Let's see here.
Sorry, Dave. This is a little behind the scenes. A little unprofessional. Apologize.
You guys use Zwick?
No, I do it.
No, good for you. He's a shithead. I hope he hears this.
Mr. Porno Man. Okay, Ray. Bump, 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 bump. It's Mr. Porno Man. Bump, 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 bump. On the Rich Dickman Show. Bump, bump, bump. Okay, here we go. Do it. Read the letter.
Greetings, gentlemen. After receiving overwhelming feedback from the Twisted Ankle Porn video that I submitted a few weeks ago, I have decided to create a throwback to the famous fetish, clamocophilia?
Oh, no.
I don't even know how to say that. As you can imagine, this one is steamy from the get-go. Not only do I incorporate some telepathy-style storytelling, the throwback setting is sure to arouse. Things quickly spiral out of control since this female has such a powerful pussy. I have no doubt this one will be even more well received than the last, and hope you enjoy every last second of it. Regards, Mr. Porterman.
This is disgusting. Ray, I'm fast forwarding here a little bit. All right. I'm not going to stream this because we'll get in trouble on Discord, but
actually, we will?
Yeah. I don't know if we will or not, but I don't want to. It's gross. I'm sorry. Okay. Let's see. Oh. Oh, God, he's went throwback. This is 80s style. Okay, so we have a...
Oh, well, what do you know?
We have a man in a jumpsuit. Oh, you know what? Let's send Dave the link so he can look. Hey, Ray, can you send Dave the link into the Discord so he can follow along?
Yeah.
Yeah. I just realized. Oh, I missed
There's
all the chat.
There's a message for you, Dave.
All right. So, you can put it in the main channel if anybody else wants to follow along with us. Oh, no, actually, Spaghetti's here. I don't. Spaghetti's, he can't watch this. All right. But this is, it's 80s style. So, you know, we're at late 70s, early 80s, probably late 70s. He's going for a retro look here. I appreciate that about you, Mr. Porno Man.
George, what are you doing here?
You asked me, remember?
Okay, hold on a second. Dave... Dave and Ray, let me ask you something real quick, all right? There is an accent that the American actors use in the 70s and early 80s, right? You guys hear this in their voice?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it disappeared. So. It disappeared probably in 1987 or whatever. It just disappeared. And nobody talks like that anymore. It's weird. Okay.
It's a good thing.
She sounds like a weirdo.
Oh, no, don't. I didn't say that. Leave me alone.
A tease, huh?
A tease. Oh, God. This guy's so creepy. He's taking his jumpsuit off.
That's what I'm here for.
Yeah, why is he wearing a jumpsuit?
You sure change when you get turned on. Don't you?
Oh, God. We can't talk like this anymore. This is terrible.
Yeah.
She's got those Jason A eyes, Dave. Randy wants you. Oh, man. That dude's not even... Mr. Porno Man, what are you doing? He's not even hard. That's disgusting. Okay. All right, I have to fast forward
randomly.
So I'm gonna go into 3 minutes and 24 seconds because I think he's talking about something. Oh, is she like? Is she turning into an animal?
She's a tiger.
What is happening?
She's a tiger.
You wanna go, Georgie?
Oh my God! She just threw him down the stairs. Oh my God, a naked man is falling down the stairs in the most...
What just happened?
Not real fashion. Looks like Donald Trump.
Oh, you got caught on his dick.
What the fuck? What happened
here? This is the weirdest
here,
shit I've ever seen.
Yeah, let's go to 259.
Move it!
Relax, baby.
What is he like?
Get it up, rubber dick!
Uh-oh.
You're really on the
weird, man.
This is the weirdest boner shit right now. What's happening?
I want more, you impotent
cocksucker. Oh, so he couldn't...
Let go of me.
He couldn't satisfy her. So her inner demon got mad,
hey,
turned into
really
a tiger.
Crazy.
You're really crazy. We're just talking about
my
that.
Clock.
What?
Well, oh, so
she's like deep, but not.
And
well,
then,
it's deep, but it's like still cheap porn.
You wanna go, Georgie?
That's like a man in there?
Like somebody thought of something.
So she just kicked him off. Yeah, she kicked him off so hard he fell down the stairs. And he fell down the wrong way.
That's big
it's like
pussy
Donald
hair.
Trump. And he's all shaky. Look how much he looks like Trump. That's so crazy. Okay, alright. We gotta talk about this one.
That was like, rape, right?
That was some sort of weird.
And then he got what he deserved?
Yeah.
After he got, so
I wouldn't say it was the R word. Okay. Happened at all because she invited him in, but he could not please her. He could not keep it up. The rubber dick comment.
Happened?
Yeah. So she wanted more. He couldn't do it. So she just, her magical powers threw him off of her and he fell down the stairs after breaking something on the wall. That's incredible.
Good
Mr.
for her.
Porno Man. Yeah. I have to, Mr. Porno Man, I have to bring back, I have to walk back what I said last week. I actually appreciate the oddness of this one.
yeah, it was strange.
Yeah. Ray, you look like you have thoughts on this.
I don't know how to gather my thoughts on this. It's just too weird.
Yeah.
Like, there's people, the thoughts, you can hear the thoughts and then things happen, but it's not quite explained, but it's kind of short. Yeah. Was it like four minutes?
Yeah, I think Mr. Porno Man like has a whole movie production in mind here and he needs to give us the rest of the context to this, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. All right, good. Dave, do you have any more thoughts on that?
We need more of this. There's got to be, that's like obviously a short clip. Like there's got to be a whole release on this.
Yeah, does she chase him down the stairs or something?
Yeah, you know, is this some sort of weird exorcist take? I don't know.
Yeah.
I mean, she was cute, so there's that, but.
You know what I think?
That's a one limp dick from me. I can't jerk off to this.
No, I don't think you're meant to. I think you're meant to think about it and discuss it with your friends afterwards. You know, like normal people that watch pornography with their friends. Appreciate Mr. Porno Man trying to reach that audience. You know, so that's good. You know what, Mr. Porno Man, good on you. I came down hard last couple of weeks and I really gave it to Randy last week because Randy hasn't been around and Mr. Porno Man was doing his bullshit again. Hey Ray, by the way. Mr. Porno Man pulled his patronage from our Patreon. Okay, he was obligated.
What?
He was out after he lost to Randy. He was obligated, and he pulled it. So I don't know why we still feature his bits on here, but something you gotta
cut him out.
You gotta think about.
Well, you gotta talk to Mr. Dickman on that, right?
Yeah, maybe Mr. Dickman. Maybe he has your secret. You know, I haven't talked to him too much past couple weeks. You know, I think he's down. He's down in one of the. Yeah, he's on one of the exploding states.
Shelter.
You know, so, yeah, he's probably in his basement sitting
there. He's hiding with Biden.
Yeah. Giving press conferences from. All right. So, hey, Dave, before we wrap up tonight, speaking of Biden, tell me, what are you doing to support the Chaz?
Nothing. No. I can't see over the horizon. Fuck them.
Yeah. Okay. All right. When Donald Trump loses this election and Joe Biden's elected president, what changes do you hope to see in this country?
None. You got an old, rich, white pedophile running against an old, rich, white pedophile. Yeah. I don't know what to tell you.
I mean, you can just be honest, say we're all fucked, right? I mean, that's...
Well, yeah, that's inferred, implied even.
Yeah.
We are all fucked, but at least fucked, you know, at least we can still pay our bills, right? Hey.
That's true, yeah. Who's starting the revolution? Because it's not Antifa, because fuck Antifa, they're a bunch of assholes. But you know, we need someone serious to start the revolution, right?
Well, it'll be digital.
It'll be digital.
Whoever does it will probably like shut down the internet or the power grid or something.
Yeah.
And then everybody dies.
Oh, God.
I got my fingers crossed. Hurry up.
It's a little darker than I expected.
Well, that's what you get.
Yeah. Hey, what is your ideal form of government in the Americas?
I know you want me to say communism.
I want you to be honest. If it's fascism, communism.
If people didn't, you know, do people things, communism would be it, but people do people things and corrupt shit and whatever. True, yeah. So let me ask you,
why, if I work very hard to make my money to support my family, why should I share that with Ray? Because fuck Ray. I don't like Ray.
Well, you're looking at it all wrong.
Oh, okay.
Why should you have to work for your money?
Oh,
scarcity
shit.
Is man-made. We throw out more food in this country than the whole world eats.
Yeah,
scarcity is literally man-made. There is enough for everyone to be comfortable and happy and do what they want. We're fighting robots. Why? That was the point. When I was a kid, oh shit, we're gonna have robots doing all our work for us. Oh, you're fucking self-checkout lanes. Go fuck yourselves. Embrace the future. Use it. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
All right.
Scared you, didn't I?
That would be that would be interesting. Like I've never spent that much time thinking about it, Dave, but I mean, yeah, if you had robots harvest all the food for us,
you know,
who's
Ray,
to say that's not just taken care of?
They've already ruined robots for us because now they're saying we're racist against robots. Okay? That's fucking bullshit.
Is that possible?
Apparently it is because they said we're racist against robots. So, you know, I don't know.
You know why? Because people are insecure. That's why.
Yeah.
And that's something you can't solve that. I don't know how you solve that. People are insecure, and that's the problem that will forever exist. Like you were saying, Dave, people are going to be people. Yep. So
people going to people.
Yeah, exactly. So there's no, I don't believe there's a solution other than In my opinion, you take care of your own business. Yeah. That's all you can do. That's
Dave's getting antsy.
And hopefully take care of your business well enough. You can make enough money to buy some robots.
But that's what Dave's saying. We don't need money, Ray. We shouldn't need, there should be no need for money. We should just be able to, just to live, you know, and have all the shit we need to live.
Yeah. So you just got to make enough money to get those robots. And then after that, you don't need any more money. So invest in robots.
Yeah.
Yes. Invest in AI.
All right. Dave, last question. Yes. What's your favorite episode of The Rich Dickman Show?
This one.
All right.
That was quick, right?
Yeah. All right. Hey, you guys
maybe it was the last one I was on. I don't know.
Yeah, that was episode 84. You can go back to Dave's first appearance on the episode here. I, you know, I'm like such a nerd in my podcast. Like, I know all the episodes between Triple T and this one, right? I don't know. I don't remember any of the Storm Ride stuff because I was always drunk, but I'm not as drunk for these.
I don't remember anything.
God bless you.
I don't remember anything.
Dave, are you guys still getting back together in person tomorrow night?
Alas, we have canceled that. We're doing it remotely again.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So who is the one you don't trust then?
The most? Me.
Yeah. Yeah.
Me.
You.
Why is that? Are you just out and about a lot?
No, because unless you tell me it's off limits, I'm going to crack a joke about it.
Nope, not off limits.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I mean, my scales are true. I don't know who did not trust the, I'm gonna have to say Dylan.
Yeah.
Cause he probably has Corona. I guarantee it. Actually.
He's had it for 6 weeks now.
He's smoking blunts with all those dudes at work and shit. Yeah.
Also, leave Dylan at home and let the rest of you guys hang out. You know, because
he's the one that seems the most afraid of it from what I've seen. Yeah.
That's funny. I don't know. I think Matt's probably the most scared of it. He's just a cool cucumber when it comes to talking about it.
Right.
In reality, I think Matt's really scared.
See,
you heard it here.
Yeah. I'm a big fan of not for human consumption, and you guys are the first podcast I play on Tuesday mornings. You guys got to get back together though, because you can't have Dylan falling asleep at the end of your shows like he does every week, man.
No, isn't it lame?
Oh, shit. He starts off, you know, this few weeks he starts off strong, and then he just peters out and falling asleep in his bed.
Well, and he's when he's here, he's like within arm's reach of me, so like he's always in fear of being molested.
Yeah.
And that keeps him on his toes and awake.
It'll keep you sober. You know, your fear of molestation, it will keep you sober around your friends.
Your cortisol sobers you up quick.
Yeah. All right, Dave, plug your shit, Dave. How do we get in touch with you?
You can hear all of my horrible garbage dick and fart jokes and inappropriate crap at nfhcpodcast.com. It's me and three of my friends, and our shtick is we're really mean to each other, like constantly. And we're on episode, we're doing 136 tomorrow night, remotely again, sadly, but patreon.com/NFHC podcast. We got a YouTube channel. We have a Pornhub channel, pornhub.com/users/NFHC podcast. And we show a lot of shit in our Discord that apparently we're not supposed to. I just found out. If it makes it to YouTube, it's censored to shit, you know. Sometimes we just can't even bother with it because we're not video editors. That's us. That's me.
What's it censored with?
They use my face to censor things, too, so that's cute. NFHCpodcast.com. Check us out. We have merch and all that shit, too. Go to our website. We got stuff. We got things going on. I'm not good at self-promotion, so...
Well, you just self-promoted. You did a hell of a job at it. So I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Yeah. Or do you have the Dave face stickers for sale on your store?
No, we're out, but I can get some more. Those were like a special order, and I sent them out with...
You see this blank space? Like
people stuff one on Patreon and shit.
See that spot right there?
You got one?
No, I want to put one there.
Oh, I got. Here's one of my video feed right here.
Yeah,
I do have a couple. We'll get together. I think I have a stack of like 10 or 12 left. So
goddamn,
hell yeah. Give me your address.
All right.
And your mother's maiden name and the last four of your social security.
All right. I can do that. No problem. Do you need, what do you need? A bank account info
too? That's easy.
Yeah. What's up? Man, I got to put $5,000 in your account for deposit.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm a prince from Nairobi.
Mm. Oh, that's fantastic. I've been looking for one to send money to. Okay. Dave, we'll talk after the show.
I'm trying not to be an asshole with you guys. I asked Matt last time he was on. I'm going to ask you now because you brought the idea up the first time you were on. But we got to get Ray to hang out with you guys for 10 minutes. You can ask him about the breast milk in his fucking refrigerator.
Oh, that's right. Yes. Yeah. I need to know about
this. It's in the freezer, which is why it's lasted so long.
Sure. Why is it in the freezer?
It's in the back.
You just haven't cleaned it out yet? How old is your youngest?
Well, now, almost 11 months.
Oh, well, I mean, so that's not, okay, that's not ridiculous. I was, if you were going to say like 6 or something, I was going to say you have 6-year-old breast milk in your freezer. That's a problem.
Is it? Some of it might be that old.
When are you guys
gonna
come on our show?
I'll have to look at the date on it and see. But
when are you guys gonna come on our show?
I'm always down, just waiting for an invite. So I just want to get Ray on your show.
Yeah,
man. Yeah.
Yeah, I'd rather have Ray. He's at least fun.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah. Fucking asshole. Fuck you, Dave. Go fuck yourself.
Thank you. That's what I'm looking for.
Weak chin bitch. Thank you guys for listening to the Rich Hickman Show. I really appreciate all the time you've given us. If you like what we do, want to support the show, tell a friend, leave a review, and feel like it's even more than that, why not check out our Patreon, patreon.com/RichDickman. Extra content every week. Right now, there is a bonus episode featuring Ray and Svensson talking about the social media war and racism and stuff. Man, they're solving problems. So check that. Ray, what are you talking about in this episode?
Well, we concluded that there's a social media cold war going on. Things just keep escalating and escalating. And hopefully, there's a stand down at some point. Because the way it's going, it's out of control.
Yeah, we can
all. But yeah, we talk about a lot of stuff. It's very interesting.
Yeah.
I'd recommend checking it out.
Subscribe. Thanks for having me, you guys. I appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem, Dave. Yeah. Thank you for coming on. We're going to be recording a bonus episode right after this one where Rem reads the emails. Patreon.com/RichDickman. Also, if you guys are just as confused as why Torrin Think Tank still has all the Marconin episodes up, go ahead, tweet them. Ask them why. All right. You can find us online, RichDickman.com, for all your Rich Dickman needs. Click that merch tab. Get yourself some t-shirts, some stickers, lots of fun stuff. We're on YouTube. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel. That'd be great. Check out all our friends, our great friends at Not For Human Consumption Podcast. Not for NFHCpodcast.com. That's where you'll find Dave. And what'd I say? RichDickmanShow@gmail.com. Find Randy at Sir Zero, executive producer Randy at Sir Zero. No, he's not on social media anymore. Randy quit social media. So you have to find him in our Discord, bit.do/TRDS1. We're on Twitter at Rich Dickman Show. I am at Rem Dickman. Producer Ryan is at Ryan TRDS. My mother, Rem_mama. And then there's Ray. What's your Twitter, Ray?
At Jules Winfeld.
Yeah, soon it'll be Ray Dickman. Yeah, all right. And finally, if you want to leave a voicemail, if you want to call us and yell at us, whatever you want to do, call the Dickman line, 860-316-4776. Again, thank you so much. This was 114. If this is my last episode, I really appreciate the time you've given to your ears for me, the time I've been able to infiltrate your ear holes into your brain and talk to you. You're all so special. Slash moo, everybody, right? Fuck off. Good night.
See ya.
Oh, Dave, that was fun. Thanks, bud.
Agreed. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, man, no problem. You can stop your track whenever, and then throw it into give it to me somehow. What are you holding up? What is that? Oh, change your username, Ray Dickman. I like it.
You see what it says?
Hey, spaghetti. Good to see you again.
That's probably spaghetti. Somebody like spaghetti already took it.
You might have. What happened to Randy? Randy, where'd you go, bud? There's Randy. Randy, did your room get redder? Did you change your camera?